In this video, we're going to talk about the sample mean. Definition: the sample mean is obtained by dividing the sum of a set of observations by the number of observations in the set. So the sample mean is represented by x bar. That's going to be equal to the sum. It's the Greek, capital Greek letter sigma, that means sum. Sum all the data points, and x will represent the data points or the observations, divided by how many observations you have. That's n. Okay, sample mean. Another way of saying sample mean would be arithmetic mean. Another way of saying sample mean could be also average. If they talk about population mean, this is not the right formula for it. Okay, so let me give you an example here. It says find the mean of the data set 9, 11, 13, 7, and 5. And in this case, yes, it's the sample mean. So how do we do that? Well, we need x bar. And then the next thing we need to do is just add all the data points. And that's going to be divided by 5 because we have 5 of those data points. And when you do the calculation, that's going to give you 9. Okay, here's another example. This time, it's going to be in a frequency table. What does that mean? Well, we have x, which is our value, and f, it's the frequency. How many times does this number occur? For example, the observation negative 2 occurs 3 times. So I have 3 observations of negative 2. Or for example, in this case, I have 2 observations of 4. And it keeps on going. If you have some type of table like this, it's actually easier using the table than rewriting all the data set. So again, we're looking for the sample mean. And what we want to do is we want to multiply the observation, negative 2, and how many times it occurs. It's kind of like a faster way of adding, right? Multiplying. So you have negative 2 times 3, or you have 3 observations of negative 2. All right, so we're going to add that to our next pair of data here. We have observation of 4, and it seems like it occurs 2 times. So again, we're just going to multiply 4 times 2. And then we multiply the next observation here. We have an observation of 5. We notice it 6 times. So 5 times 6. And then the next one is 7 times 2. The observation is 7, but we see it 2 times. So 7 times 2. And then the last one, 10 times 7. All divided by 20. Now, how did we get 20? Well, the frequency count. What's the total frequency count? And you add that up, it's going to give you 20 observations. Then we do the math. Negative 2 times 3 is going to give you negative 6. 4 times 2 is 8, and so forth. And then you divide that by 20. Then you add the top, and then you divide by 20. And that's going to give you 5.8. I created another video if you want to know what's the mean measuring. Yes, it's measuring the center. And there are two other ways of measuring the center. That would be the mode and the median. But the mean has a certain property. It's a way to balance the data. It's like where in the data would you find the balance of that data? That's what the mean is giving you. And also, the mean also gives you a number of what would it be like if all the data points were the same. Well, that's kind of weird of saying that, but if you want to know a little more about the mean and what is it suggesting in the data, go ahead and watch my video on that. Okay, so that's it.